Dyson Dilemmas. Could we really build a megastructure around a star? Imagine standing on a structure so vast that if you tried to walk its circumference, you would circle the distance from Earth to the Sun 628 times. Beneath your feet, trillions of solar panels drink starlight, harvesting more energy in a single second than humanity has used in our entire history. Above you, the star that once lit a solar system now serves as the beating heart of a civilization that has transcended planetary limitations. This is not science fiction. This is the Dyson Sphere. And today we are diving into one of the most audacious engineering proposals ever conceived. But here is the question that will haunt us. Just because we could build a cage around a star, should we? The dreamer and his vision. In 1960, a brilliant physicist named Freeman Dyson was pondering a profound problem. He was not thinking about rockets or computers. He was thinking about energy, growth, and the ultimate limits of civilization. Dyson realized that any advanced civilization would face an inevitable energy crisis. Not because they would run out of fossil fuels, but because they would run out of planet. Think about it like this. If human energy consumption continues growing at just 2.3% per year, a conservative estimate, we would need to harvest the entire energy output of the Sun within about 1,400 years. That is not 1,400 years from now. That is equivalent to the time between today and the year 600, when the Byzantine Empire was at its peak. Dyson's radical solution? Do not just live near a star, build around it, capture everything. But here is where Dyson's genius shines. He never actually proposed a solid sphere. That Hollywood image of a rigid shell encasing the sun? It is a physics nightmare. A solid sphere would be gravitationally unstable, structurally impossible, and would cook anything living on its inner surface to a crisp. Instead, Dyson envisioned something far more elegant. A swarm. Picture a trillion solar collectors, each the size of a small moon, orbiting the sun in a complex dance. Some closer, some farther, all working together to form a loose shell of energy-harvesting technology. It is not a sphere. It is a symphony of satellites, a mechanical ecosystem orbiting in perfect harmony. The physics of ambition. Let us get our hands dirty with the numbers, because they are staggering. Our sun pumps out 3.8 times 10 to the 26th power watts of power every single second. To put that in perspective, if you could capture just 0.00000001% of the sun's output, a fraction so small it is practically invisible, you would have enough energy to power current human civilization. Capture it all, and you would have enough energy to power quadrillions of Earth-like civilizations. But building such a structure would require materials on a scale that makes our wildest engineering projects look like sandcastles. Conservative estimates suggest we would need to dismantle several planets' worth of matter. Mercury alone, our innermost planet, contains roughly 3.3 times 10 to the 23rd power kilograms of material, mostly iron, silicon, and magnesium. That might be enough for a basic Dyson swarm if we could somehow transport, refine, and construct with every single atom. Here is where the engineering gets deliciously complex. You cannot just build solar panels and throw them around the sun. Each collector needs to maintain its orbit, communicate with the others, and beam energy back to wherever the civilization lives. We're talking about a distributed network more complex than every computer system on Earth combined, operating across distances that would take light minutes to traverse. And then there is the heat problem. The second law of thermodynamics is unforgiving. All that collected energy has to go somewhere. A Dyson Sphere civilization would necessarily radiate waste heat into space. In fact, this is how astronomers are actively searching for such structures right now. They are looking for stars that appear dimmer in visible light, but brighter in infrared radiation. The telltale signature of artificial energy collection. Surprisingly, we have not found any obvious candidates yet. The star KESC8462852, dubbed Tabby's Star, caused excitement in 2015 when it displayed strange dimming patterns. Could it be partially enclosed by alien megastructures? Probably not. The latest data suggests natural phenomena like dust clouds or comet swarms, but the search continues. The philosophical abyss. Here is where our scientific journey takes a sharp turn into profound philosophical territory. Building a Dyson sphere is not just an engineering challenge. It is a statement about what kind of civilization we want to become. Consider the implications. The Dyson Sphere civilization has essentially enslaved a star. They have taken a natural nuclear fusion reactor that has burned for billions of years, providing light and warmth to entire planetary systems, and turned it into an industrial battery. Every photon that once traveled freely through space now serves a single species' ambitions. This raises haunting questions about our relationship with nature. Throughout human history, we have gradually expanded our dominion over the natural world. We have dammed rivers, leveled forests, and reshaped continents. A Dyson sphere represents the ultimate expression of this impulse, the complete technological subjugation of cosmic forces. But there is another way to look at it. Perhaps a Dyson sphere represents the highest form of efficiency and responsibility. Instead of letting 99.999999% of the sun's energy radiate uselessly into empty space, a mature civilization captures and utilizes it. From this perspective, building such a structure is not conquest, it is stewardship. The ethical implications multiply when we consider what comes next. With effectively unlimited energy, a civilization faces new choices. Do they spread across the galaxy, building more spheres around more stars? Do they focus inward, creating virtual realities of unimaginable complexity? Do they attempt to upload consciousness itself, creating trillions of digital beings who exist as pure information? And here is the most unsettling question. Would such a civilization still be recognizably human? The scale of engineering required, the timeframes involved, the sheer abundance of energy, all of this might fundamentally transform the species that builds it. We might be discussing the emergence of something that transcends biology entirely. Let us explore three possible futures, three different paths a civilization might take toward building these megastructures. The first is the gradual path. Solar system industrialization. This is perhaps the most plausible scenario. Instead of attempting a full Dyson sphere immediately, humanity might spend the next several centuries gradually industrializing our solar system. We start by mining asteroids for raw materials, building massive solar arrays in space, and constructing O'Neill cylinders, rotating space habitats that provide artificial gravity. Over time, these efforts scale up. We dismantle Mercury for its metals, build self-replicating robotic factories, and slowly surround the sun with an ever-denser swarm of collectors. This process might take thousands of years, but each step builds naturally on the last. By the time we complete our Dyson swarm, we are no longer a single planet species. We are a true stellar civilization. The second path is the exponential path, von Neumann proliferation. Named after mathematician John von Neumann, this path relies on self-replicating machines. We build the first generation of space-based factories by hand, but each generation builds the next one faster and more efficiently. The growth becomes exponential. 2 become 4, 4 become 8, 8 become 16. Under this scenario, a Dyson sphere could be completed in mere centuries. The catch? Controlling exponential growth is notoriously difficult. One small programming error, one unexpected mutation in the replication process, and you might end up with grey goo. Self-replicating machines that convert everything, including planets and stars, into more of themselves. The third possibility is the quantum leap path. Breakthrough physics. What if our current understanding of physics is fundamentally incomplete? Throughout history, revolutionary discoveries have made the impossible routine. Maxwell's equations enabled radio. Quantum mechanics enabled computers. General relativity enabled the global positioning system. Perhaps there are principles we have not discovered yet. Ways to manipulate matter and energy that would make Dyson sphere construction trivial. Room temperature fusion, programmable matter, or even controlled manipulation of fundamental forces could transform mega-engineering from a centuries-long project into something achievable within a human lifetime. The strangest aspect of the Dyson sphere concept might be this. By seriously considering it, we are forced to confront who we are and who we might become. Right now, as you listen to this, radio telescopes around the world are scanning nearby star systems for infrared signatures that might indicate alien Dyson spheres. The Breakthrough Listen project, funded partly by tech billionaires who made their fortunes thinking about exponential growth, is actively searching for these megastructures. But here is the twist. Every time we look for alien Dyson spheres, we are also looking at our own potential future. We're asking whether intelligence inevitably leads to this kind of cosmic engineering, whether the arc of technological development naturally bends towards stellar-scale construction projects. If we find alien Dyson spheres, it suggests that intelligence tends toward expansion and energy maximization. If we do not find them, it raises even more interesting questions. Are advanced civilizations too wise to build them? Too afraid? Do they discover something about the universe that makes such projects unnecessary or impossible? Or perhaps the most unsettling possibility? Maybe advanced civilizations build Dyson spheres, harvest their stars completely, and then disappear. Not through war or catastrophe, but through transformation into something so alien, so post-biological, that we would not recognize them as life at all. We began with a simple question. Could we build a megastructure around a star? The answer is probably yes. The physics works, the materials exist, and the energy rewards are beyond imagination. But as we have seen, the real question is not about engineering tolerances or orbital mechanics. It is about choice. Every photon our sun emits carries not just energy, but possibility. Right now, most of that possibility streams past Earth and disappears into the cosmic dark, never to be seen again. A Dyson sphere would capture that possibility, harvest it, and transform it into something unprecedented. A civilization with energy resources limited only by the lifetime of stars themselves. Such a civilization could build worlds, encode minds, or explore realms of existence we cannot even imagine. But it would also mark the end of something precious. The wild, untamed beauty of a natural star system, where light travels freely and planets dance in the dark. Standing at this crossroads, looking up at the sun that has nurtured every living thing on Earth, we are left with a choice that defines not just our future, but our soul. Do we reach out and embrace the stars, making them our own? Or do we find another way to grow, to flourish, to become more than we are? The sun does not answer. It just keeps burning, 93 million miles away, waiting to see what we decide.